Hello everyone, today's lecture is on work culture and in this topic we will cover the meaning of work culture, importance and components that are the elements which determine the work culture in the organization. Before going to the meaning of organizational culture or work culture, we should know about the meaning of culture. So culture is the set of values, beliefs, ideologies, preferences that are shared by the members of a community. For example, values and beliefs shared by the people of Hindu religion, values and beliefs shared by the Christian peoples according to the Christian religions. So now the organizational culture is a set of values, philosophies, attitudes, beliefs, assumptions, expectations that guide an organization together and are shared by its employees. Culture of the organization plays a very important role in the area of motivating the employees. Organizational culture can be referred to the norms and values of the organization which together make the personality of the company. Now, the importance of a healthy work culture. The first one is the means in this topic we will know the importance why a healthy work culture is needed in the organization. The first point is employee retention. Employee retention means every company wants to retain its employees, because if it lose their employees, it makes them very costly to hire another person, and it took time to train the new employee according to the culture of the organization. So if there is a healthy work culture in the organization, no such problem will be faced by the organization. So the first point is employee retention. Then second is the reputation. Companies with a healthy corporate culture gain a positive reputation among potential workers, which may attract talented and skilled workers to the organization. So we can say that if a company wants to maintain its reputation, it should give a healthy work culture to its employees for the working. Now the third point is productivity. If an organization wants to increase the productivity of the workers by increasing the morale of the workers, it can be happen only by providing a healthy work culture to its employees or workers. So when workers increase productivity, the financial health of the organization improves and profit also increases. So increase in productivity are a measure that illustrate efficiencies and effectiveness in the company. The next point is quality. Healthy corporate cultures encourage workers to deliver quality products and services. Companies with cultures valuing the highest standards create an atmosphere for workers to deliver products that meet those standards. So for the organization, if it demands quality in the production or any working area, it should provide a healthy work culture to the employees. The next one is employees must be cordial with each other. Here they should organization culture should be there, like the employees go with the integrity, they come up with the integrity of the employees, means one must respect his fellow worker. The next one is each employee should be treated as one. So for a healthy work culture, it is mandatory that every employee is treated equally. There should be no partiality in the organization, because if it exists, then the loyalty and the morality of the employee decreases, which will harm the organization in the long run. Next one is appreciating the top performers is important. In this, if you want the good ideas to be initiated by the employees every time, then you should reward the employee एट द करेंट टाइम हु प्रोवाइड यू द गुड आइडिया और अ बुलेट प्रूफ आइडिया विच इज़ वेरी यूजफुल टू द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. सो इफ़ यू एनकरेज द एम्प्लॉयज बाई गिविंग अ इक्वली रिवॉर्डेड, देन द एम्प्लॉयज फील, देन द मॉरल ऑफ द एम्प्लॉयज बूस्ट एंड दे विल कम अगेन विद द मोर बेस्ट आइडियाज इन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. So the next one is organization must have employees friendly policies and practical guidelines. This point itself explain that an organization must have clear policies and the guidelines should be practical so that every employee can maintain the decorum of the organization. As the discipline is a very important for the workplace situations. Next one is promote team building activities to bind the employees together. Conduct training programs, workshops, seminars and presentations to upgrade the existing skills of the employees. Prepare them for the tough times. They should be ready under any odd circumstances or change in the work culture. Now come to the components or the we can say elements which determine the healthy work culture, or you can say work culture which determines the work culture of the organization. The first one is a vision. How vision determines the work culture? For example, if we take the example of RPS institution, it is a college or in this area, in this institution you will get the environment kind of study. Here the relationship of teachers and students are you can see here. In corporate sector, their vision is like to maximize the profit. So a great culture starts with a vision or a mission statement. These simple turns of phrase guide a company's values and provide it with purpose. So the purpose is shown by the vision, mission, objective statements of the organization, and it clarifies the work culture. What should be the work culture of the organization? In a corporate sector, you will find the different work culture. In the education sector, you will find the different work culture in the organization. Now the ownership. Second element to determine the work culture is the ownership. Ownership is about giving people the opportunity to be accountable for their results without being micromanaged. Means here the if the organization follows a centralization process of decision making, means the power of decision making is in the few hands of the organization, then the employees will feel that their decisions, their advices and suggestions are not important for the organization, and they will not think creatively in near future. And if the organization adopts the decentralization process of making decision making, it will boost the morale of the employees, as now they also get the chance to make the decisions on the activities which are performed by them. The next one is organizational values. Organizational values reflect what we feel is important. Means here the organization have the core values that reflect what is important in the organization. For example, for the RPS group of institutions, it is important to deliver the knowledge to the students whatever the condition is. We can take the example of the current situation, as the every staff of RPS group of institution are engaging themselves in providing the knowledge to their students in every possible via every possible way. Now the organizational beliefs are the part of organization culture, as the beliefs helps the best ways to achieve certain goals such as increasing productivity and job motivation. See, these methods, as if we talk about the current situation of the of our world, here you can see that from RBI, from every institutions, the teachers are facing so many difficulties to provide to interact with their students effectively and efficiently. So they are finding day by day a new platforms to interact with their students. On what belief? On that belief that their student will also study, their student will not be harmed by the current situation. They should get the every possible study material in a time. Now the organizational norms. Organizational norms. Norms is basically reflects the rules and regulations in the in any organization. So norms basically depicts the meaning of rules and regulation. So organizational norms reflect the typical and accepted behaviors in the organization. Means what kind of behavior is accepted in the organization. What you have do's. What you have not don'ts. These are explained in this. So for working in an organization, you will find that there are procedures, some regulations, rules and regulations that you have to follow while working in the organization. So if there are so many rules and regulations in the organization, it is difficult for the employees to work properly. Hence, the rules and regulations should be minimal, or you can say that which are practical to implement by the employees so that they cannot harm the productivity of the employees. The next one is effective communication. Effective communication is like, as we know, as we study about the communication, importance of communication. So yes, the communication plays a very important role to create the work culture in the organization. Here, if there is a effective communication network is established in the organization, that is to communicate freely or you can communicate easily with the higher authority, then the work culture is very healthy in the organization. But if the network of the communication is very complex and is very formal, that is then it will delay the communication, which will affect the productivity of the organization. The last one is the good leadership. Here, if in the organization there are good leaders, then it will boost the morale of the employees, as the leader knows the every employees of the organization which are working under them, under him or her, and he or she, the leader, I'm talking about the leader, the leader knows the strength and weakness of the followers, and he or she is able to motivate the employees or to increase the productivity of the employees at the end. So if the good leadership exists in the organization, or you can say if the good leaders are present in the organization, they create a very healthy work culture in the organization. So that's all for today, guys. Thank you.